Check, mic check. Check, mic check. Check, mic check. Check, mic check.
Check. Thank you. Kindly stand. We will sing When the Sun Has Set and the Night Is On, hymn number 456.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we have gathered here today to commend our dear brother Roy to the Lord. We thank God for the gift of his life, for the amount of people he has touched in his life, and the crowds here are testimony of that. We thank God for the gift he was to his family and to all of us here. What God has given us, we give back to God today. Our faith teaches us that with death, life is not ended but changed. With belief in that promise, we celebrate this Eucharist, knowing that Roy will now share a new life with our risen Lord. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Roy, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and no torment will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seem to have died, and their departure was thought to be an evil thing, and their going from us to be their destruction. But they are at peace. For though in the sight of men they were punished, their hope is full of immortality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great good, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Like gold in the furnace, he tried them. And like a sacrificial whole burnt offering, he accepted them. Those who trust in him will understand truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are always upon his holy ones. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly stand for the responsorial song.
No, please be seated. Kindly join us in singing hymn number 388. Hymn number 388. The Lord is my shepherd.
Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord, that they may rest from their labors, for their deeds follow them.
Glory, glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to the crowds, "All that the Father gives me will come to me, and whoever comes to me, I will never cast out. For I have come down from heaven, not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who looks on the Son and believes in him should have eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise, praise, praise to you, Jesus, now and evermore.
My dear brothers and sisters, About a week ago, R.P. Roy had sent me a message to say I'm going to be admitted to an Induja hospital. I'll be undergoing an angiography on Monday, an open heart surgery on Tuesday. And if all goes well, by 24th March, I will be back. Unfortunately, it never happened. I assured him of my prayers, and I'm sure many prayed, but God willed it otherwise. And therefore, his passing away has come so sudden to everyone, unexpectedly, which reminds us that finally life and death is not in our hands. It is God who gives life, God who takes life. We don't know when it can happen. We may have our own plans, everything, but finally our life is in God's hand, and he takes it whenever he wills it. What's important for us, therefore, is not how long we live, but how well we live our life. And I believe that Roy was a man who lived his life fullest, because he was a man full of life. I've known him, of course, as a schoolboy at Mahim, but even more when I was here for 3 years, I saw him always full of life, so happy to come and speak to me, always wanted to be involved in the church and whatever you gave him, very responsible. That was the man that he was, a man who could be entrusted with things, and he did it totally, wholeheartedly. My dear brothers and sisters, finally, that is what remains. What remains are not the things that we do, but rather the memories that we leave behind, the good that we do to people, the good that we do to the church, the service that we render to the church and to society. These are things that remain beyond death. My dear brothers and sisters, said a death like his can sometimes shake in our faith, where we keep asking questions, why had all this to happen? But I think we need to thank God for giving us a faith that help us realize that this is not the end. As the Book of Wisdom says, that for those who don't have faith, this seems to be an end of a life that we are living. So good life, suddenly it goes away. But for those who have faith, it's not the end. As Father Anil said, life has changed, but not ended. And that is the good news that we have. That beyond all our pain of separation, of losing someone so close to us, we know that now he is in God's hand. He has gone to a place where there is no more pain, no more tears, no more sadness. A place where all of us long to go, a place where all of us will one day be and be united with each other. And therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, I believe every death is a reminder to us that one day we too will go to the same journey of life. One day we too will pass through it, and we must be prepared all times. God, we don't know when it will happen. It's important to be prepared. Our life must be a preparation for death, so it does not matter when death comes. But finally, to give our best to God and to people. My dear brothers and sisters, today, it is definitely a moment of grief for all the family people who lost him so suddenly and unexpectedly. No one ever thought he would go so soon. But we believe that God never abandons us. God strengthens us. And we believe that the dead continue to live in the lives of people, that that Roy will continue to help his family from heaven, where we all will one day be. My dear brothers and sisters, today let us thank God for the gift of R.P. Roy to his family, to society, and to the church. There's been an active man. This active life has come to an end. But finally, we are sure that we will reach the glorious life together, where one day we'll be united with all our brothers and sisters and with him in eternal life with Jesus' love. Amen.
Kindly join us in singing the offertory hymn, All That I Am.
Dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Roy, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Hosanna in the highest.
God, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of our faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Oswald, our Bishop, all the bishops and all the clergy.
Remember our brother Roy, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a meaningful sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
This is Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. This is Jesus who shares his new life with Roy today. Happy are we who now share in this banquet of love.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
In the body and blood of Christ, keep us all safe for eternal life.
Kindly note, Communion is only for Catholics. Christ Sharir sirf Christiyon ke liye hai. Hamare anya dharma ke bhaiyon aur behne jo maujood hai, kripya apni jagah pe baithke prarthana kare. Dhanyavad.
For the communion hymn, kindly join us in singing hymn number 43, hymn number 43, As the Deer. Hymn number 43. Number 55, Be Not Afraid.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother Roy may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. Somebody speaking?
Man, thou art dust, and to dust thou shalt return. That was said on the first day, on Ash Wednesday, when the Lenten services started. It hurts us today when the person we love most, and my only brother, sleeps there looking at me. It hurts us that he has done so much to society. He has given his heart out, sometimes even shelled out from his own pocket. I know it because he shares a lot with me. He is a man who stands tall even among the giants, because he thinks big. He thinks for all. That was his nature. He never thought for himself as such. He was a man of the millions. There was always a phrase he used to say, and he used to tell us multiple times, if I enter a party, I don't know anybody. When I leave the party also, I don't know anybody, but everybody knows me. That's Roy in a nutshell. He was very forgetful with names. Even with the crowds, he helped. He kept forgetting their names, but he never made them realize that he couldn't recollect their names. He kept them engaged. That was what he was, a people person, a person who did think of the masses, a person who did think of doing things for the masses. Never thought it would hurt him. He always thought how to improve the lives of everybody around him. A living example, for the last 3 years, he was in charge of the Oshiwara Cemetery. He's going there to lay down his life. He was in charge of that cemetery, and he used to often tell me, whenever I used to pass that way, to get down and see for yourself what I have done. Yesterday night I was there marking a grave with his son. I was watching all the beauties he has done and what are changes. Earlier it was a jungle, today it is a beautiful garden. That's what he likes to do. He likes to leave behind his footprints in the sands of life. He always tells me, do not amass any property or wealth, but learn to amass the blessings of others. He's not only my brother, but he's my hero. I respect him more than I love him. He taught me a lot in my way of life. He taught me to stand tall when I was a very quiet person. But today I stand in front of this crowd talking to you. It's only because of him. He was a person who was full of life, very active, always wanted to cheer up everybody, even in a dead moment. And an example of that is the 2 years of COVID we had. Everything was locked down. He kept telling me, we need to do something, I need to do something. Otherwise, people will go bonkers. And that's where he started this Zoom. And he started playing houses for the masses, the senior citizens, the sick and the lay who are at home through this Zoom. He also, with that addition, he kept on adding on by having events so as to meet our old Hussein Colony crowd, our old school crowd, the old alumni of our engineering college. We both went to the same college. We often did this in order to keep in touch. He was a people person. He liked that everybody should interact with everybody, even amongst our cousins, even among our relatives far abroad, even in USA, Canada, everywhere. They all accuse, come on the day when he calls them. It's because of his love of only sharing that joy with everybody. That is my brother Roy. Today he lies in the coffin, but he has left an imprint in our hearts. He lies down peaceful because he's with God. But he has made us cry. He lies down because he wants to, he thinks, he was telling us also one more thing before he went for his grandchild's Holy Communion, that he wants to come back because he wants to fight the illness. He wants to, he's got a lot left in his life, he says. It never ends. Till the last moment, he kept saying that. That is my brother Roy. I do not know how many of you know, but he's a powerful writer. He always believed the pen is mightier than the sword. So he never fought with people, but he always created a dialogue with people in order to resolve problems. Let it be between families, between brothers, between society, between neighbors. His whole ambition was to enrich the society and to leave everybody happy, make everybody feel the need of living in a society that's created by God. He also did a lot of church service, community service. He also brought in a lot of people to give advice on tax, on medicals, on various forms of life, so that's to help the people to understand how to survive and live in this world. He stands tall today, and we feel whatever he has done is too big to finish, even in this small statement that I make. Today, I am proud to be his brother. I was always his brother, but I'm proud to be his brother. And I'm proud to the fact that he lives in our hearts and in our minds. Thank you very much. But I'll request each and every one of you, whoever leaves from here to the cemetery also, to put your hand to your heart and remember that Roy always lived for others. He always lived that we should develop a society of love and affection. Thank you.
This is going to be tougher than I thought. Dada used to say, when you think of me, I want you to remember me through my words and my actions. So last night, because we were doing a vigil, my brother and I sat by his casket, and I did the one thing that he had asked me all these years to do, and I never did. I read through tens of his blogs. I just kept reading and reading and reading, and time just went by. And in his blogs, after 39 years of being resilient to a lot of his ideologies and the way he saw life, I realized that what he really shepherded were values of grit, of love, of compassion, of helping humanity. And that's where he leaves behind his legacy today for all of us. Dada, you brought your energy, your personality, your vibe into everything, every person that you touched. You made it clear that R.P. Roy had not just a vision, but he had a zeal to make it happen. Your charisma, your wit, and your live life R.P. Roy size have left an impression on everyone here. And for the times when things didn't work out, he had his favorite phrase, Kaliwali, which means don't bother. Dada, wherever you are, you will lead us. And if Kris and I can even become half the person that you are, we would consider ourselves blessed. Dada, we miss you terribly. Thank you.
You're announcing the Mansmain Mass details?
Yeah, the Memorial Mass will be on the 25th of March in this parish at 7 p.m. The 25th of March at 7 p.m.
The Lord be with you. Please stand.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go forth in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
With faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our brother Roy to be buried in its human imperfection. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that he will raise up this mortal body to the perfection and the company of the saints. May God give him a merciful judgment and forgive all his sins. May Christ the Good Shepherd lead him safely home to be at peace with God, our Father. And may he be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the eternal King. Our response will be, receive his soul and present it to God the Most High.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to his aid. Come to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Father, into your hands we commend our brother. We are confident that with all who died in Christ, he will be raised to life on the last day and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave him in this life to show your fatherly care for all of us and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayers. Welcome our brother to the paradise and help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith until we all meet in Christ to be with you and with our brother forever. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We will now proceed to the cemetery.
Kindly note, the family has arranged a bus. There are two buses waiting at the Anandar Kamar, which is on the side of the church, for those of you who wish to go to the cemetery. Thank you.
kindly join us in singing the hymn, Precious Lord.
When my way thousand to wait for 5 minutes, still do something itself. Mm-hmm. You have 1,000 to wait for 5 minutes, 5 minutes to wait for.
Okay, maybe your family is not yet coming. All of them are coming. Please come.
Thank you. right? She's old.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, by the 3 days you lay in the tomb, you made holy graves of all who believe in you. Even though the bodies lie in the earth, they trust that they, like you, will rise again. Give our brother peaceful rest in this grave until the day when you, the resurrection and the life, rise him up in a glory. Then he see the light of your presence, Lord Jesus, in the kingdom where we live forever and ever.
Amen.
Since Almighty God has called our brother from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth from which it was made. Christ was the first to rise from the dead. We know that he will raise up our mortal bodies to be like in his glory. We commend our brother to the Lord. May the Lord receive him into his peace and raise his body on the last day. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life, the man who believes in me will live even if he dies. And every living person puts his faith in me will never suffer eternal death. He was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him the place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. After each prayer, our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Thank you. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we wept at the death of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. Our response,
Lord, hear our prayer.
You raise the dead to life. Give our brother eternal rest. Our response,
Lord,
we repented. Bring us to the joys of heaven. Our response,
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother was washed clean in baptism, anointed with the oil of salvation. Give him a fellowship with all your saints. Our response,
Lord, hear our prayer.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our brother. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Our response,
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, listen to our prayer for our brother as he was always desire to do your will. In your mercy, forgive whatever wrong he may have done. By his Christian faith, he may be united with all your believing people. Now in love and mercy, give him a place with you, with the angels and the saints. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We say all together, our Father,
our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed
be
thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Lord, your light shine upon him, for he is our Father.
Those who would like to pay their last respects, please come forward. Keep moving from both the sides. So.
Thank you.
They will cover the face. Stay here only.
Come, finish. No, that's not.
Not really. Pulling the kerchief here or the kerchief here? Stay here only. Fine.
What is it?
They got there, the car got lost. The driver didn't know the way and they got lost.
So what is called inspected?
No. So blood TC? Yes, check.
Just a minute. Can I have the very immediate family member standing there for one picture, last picture there?
Call mom. Your immediate
family member.
Carol?
Very immediate family.
Call Emma.
Get the immediate family and then.
We'll come here, this is outside.
We are waiting.
This is outside.
Anybody is coming?
No, there are two.
Who's covered?
Both the sons.
Sons are different.
This thing of bookcase is
coming. There, my father. Hold it. Chris.
All close family members. Just take one last photo. Close family members. Just give.
Just go little behind. Little behind. Just y'all also. Little behind.
Can you hold the kerchief now? The immediate family, please. Okay, and cover the face. Okay.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Cover the face. Okay. Your right hand on the coffin and just let the photographer take one picture. Done?
1 minute. Okay, yeah, done.
Now we move to proceed.
Stand the other side there. So, up here.
Yes.
Let me either. I just want to center me.
Ah, just up.
This is just going to be this. All the families stand there. Take care. Thank you. Follow the rules.
Sir, yeah, bah, yeah. Up, up, up. Thank you.
Leave.
Can I have the family member standing in center there?
Storm through the night, lead me on to
precious Lord, lead me home. This world is not my home, I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. I have a loving mother just over in glory land, and I don't expect to stop until I shake her hand. She's waiting now for me in heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Just over in glory land, we'll live eternally. The saints on every hand are shouting victory. Their songs of sweetest praise drip back from heaven's shore, and I can't this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world.
Come. Remember our most gracious persons, and never was it known that anyone could make a type of